So,
how you think it sounds? You like it?
Hey, give me the show, like the big show.
Oh, one of them I do is the full action on here and everything.
So you open that, right? You open all.
Yeah, I open all of
right, this. Show, right.
I make sure that this is gone, mm-hmm. so they can actually see that. If one of these bars are here, right here,
yes, sir.
It's protected, mm-hmm. so the keys won't fly out. You
right,
know,
right.
And then I can. You out on blues, which is 1-4-1-5. So you take a C chord, just like, you know, just right over one. What I do, play note, skip a note, play note, skip a note, play note, mm-hmm. C chord. And then I take the C and move it up here. And then I add an A. So this is just gonna 1-1-1-4-1-5. Thank you. this. This song is called The Night Has a Thousand Eyes. It's by Bobby B. And it's, let's see, goes on.
Thank you. If you don't have fun, don't do it.
When I used to, my first, very, very first song was four chopsticks. So I took that and went,
thank you. week.
Oh yeah. Yeah, you would start with the basics. I'll be easy with you. Yeah. Oh, that's it. That's the other. That's for this. Yeah, it's for the leg.
Yeah, that's one exactly.
Well, we could change the wheels on this.
Yeah, we'll
too.
Change them. We'll put the plastic, the one that you have from the black one.
Yeah. And the piano might be a little bit higher because of the wheels, but it's easier on your floors.
Okay.
And it'll be great. So next time we'll definitely.
We'll fix the wheels on all of both of them and paint them. That's gonna be a job.
No, what's that?
We're gonna paint the other piano.
Yeah, we'll paint the other piano.
Right. But don't you have a nice Polish, you can paint these?
No, this you can use Old English.
Old English?
Yeah, just rub Old English on it, but you can't, after you rub it on, take an old t-shirt and rub it on.
Rub it on.
Make sure you don't get it on the keys.
Exactly.
Because it will color the keys. Okay. But get the Old English that has stain remover, and it'll make it a little bit darker.
Mm-hmm.
It'll make it darker and it'll polish
Where
it up.
Where buy that? Where buy all that?
Oh, at Home Depot or Lowe's.
Okay.
Yeah. And make sure you can take this off and get in here, but make sure it doesn't get on the hammer.
Yes, definitely. Not that with the mechanism.
Yeah. This is a good piano. Yeah, I knew it was a Kimball because I was looking at different parts and because this is not the only company that tried to hide that name. Kimball, what happened is that Kimball had a fallout.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And not that many people respected them until after, because Kimball bought Busenhofer.
Mm-hmm.
You know the name Busenhofer?
No, sir.
Busenhofer is a very, very high quality piano.
Yeah, okay.
And Busenhofer has more than 88 keys. It has like 96 keys. Mm-hmm. And then what happened is that Busenhofer Kimball sold was an offer to Yamaha,
mm-hmm.
and everything like that, but Kimball was not a piano anymore. They made Kimball these days still makes hospital furniture.
Mm.
Yeah.
So why nobody wanted to use them? What was it?
Back in the 80s and back in the 80s and 90s, it was more popular,
mm-hmm.
and stuff like that. Even in it's probably up to 2008, it was more popular. Baldwin, Wurlitzer.
Yeah, it's another good piano.
Yeah.
Right?
And everybody wanted Yamaha and Steinway.
Mm-hmm.
But Baldwin was on the top of its chain, so Baldwin kind of put them out of business and everything. And I love Baldwin piano, so. And Kimball, not that many Kimballs that I play are like this at all, because there's a lot of Kimballs I have to keep on tweaking.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes they sound too tinny.
Mm-hmm.
This one doesn't sound tinny at all. It has that
soft touch, yeah?
Yeah. I mean, if you do, you can't do that on another Kimball. Thank you. changed. Right here, it could be a lot lower if I voiced it a little bit lower. But you hear that, if I press the pedal, this is without pressing the pedal. So if I play the same notes, pressing the pedal, it's different. And then we're here.
Oh, thank you.